Good morning, folks. We've got weather, earthquake news, water movement, and a supernova surprise. We're starting with our star, however, over at spaceweathernews.com. Find the last 24 hours on the sun still displaying dark coronal holes and bright umbral magnetic fields. As we've been seeing for weeks, the active regions do not have any umbral cores beneath them. There are no sunspots right now, and therefore solar flaring remains flatlined. Those active regions are merely surface magnetic areas. Meanwhile, the solar wind is calm as well. No further intensifications as we stare down a large coronal hole wrapping back around the sun. The lack of solar wind thus far has the KP even lower to where cosmic ray health concerns are just a few steps further into low solar activity. I do hope you caught our upload yesterday discussing the magnitude 6.9 earthquake that struck Indonesia at the Rinjani volcano. That mountain is a cold mark on our species' history. Almost 100 dead, and the numbers are rising. Let's quickly go to the satellites with day-night cloud phase and lightning overlays. Here in the new Valley of the Sun, we didn't get much. We were able to catch one step leader reversing into four return strikes along the connected circuit. But the real weather stories right now are tropical. Hurricane Hector still set to swing just towards the southern coasts of Hawaii. System off the American coastlines begin to shift north, but not enough to come at land. They do begin to go west at the end. Meanwhile, that's not at all the case in the West Pacific. The system is going to run up the east coast of Japan here soon and then to the northeast. Excellent satellite images of that storm so far coming in from Himawari. So these animations are part of a 3D snow and ice motion study aimed at better understanding the science of avalanches. Pretty cool 3D looks from a variety of perspectives. But let's go next to the other kind of scary water motion, the tsunami. New study has tied dozens of mass grave sites in both the Pacific Rim and Europe to massive tsunamis. They say the tsunami effect over time may need to rewrite the history books in terms of colonization and collapse. Up next, hidden in plain sight, barely any visible trace, a gorgeous figure in deep space shines from infrared to X-ray in a big way. And the composite image of these wavelengths provides a ghostly remnant of a stellar explosion. They have been looking for the binary survivor of the supernova for decades, but it turns out there isn't one. They claim that three distinct explosions occurred here, both stars are gone, making for the odd, twisting remnant, and at the heart, once again, nothing at all. We've got your wind maps and shots of our star to close. We greatly appreciate your support. We'll do this all again tomorrow, right here, but right now it's 4:45 a.m. in the new Valley of the Sun. Eyes open, no fear. Be safe, everyone.